In 1966, a pulp and paper mill was constructed at Baikalsk on the eastern shore of the lake. The plant was initially commissioned to make high-grade wood pulp for industrial and military purposes. Inside the pulp mill, the process is much the same as it was when the plant was built. Logs are converted into a slurry of bleached wood fibers. Huge dryers convert the liquid slurry into rolls of solid pulp. The drying process releases billowing white clouds of pure water vapor into the atmosphere. Water from earlier stages of the process is eventually returned to the lake, where it could pose a threat to the unique ecosystem. Coal is used to fire the furnaces, which provide the heat needed to dry the pulp. Combustion of the coal creates acidic gases, which pollute the trees on hills and mountains downwind of the plant. In the early years, the philosophy of taking everything from nature meant that risks were ignored or unrecognized.
Как-то так сложилось у нас сначала, я считаю, не только у нас, а во всей стране, что технологии производства продукции были сами собой, а технологии защиты окружающей среды сами собой. Технологии, что хотели, производили, и сбрасывали в сточные воды, в выбросы в атмосферу столько, сколько им надо было по технологии загрязнений.
From the beginning, there was opposition to the very existence of the mill. The plant provoked one of the earliest and most significant environmental controversies in the Soviet Union. It became a focus for the fledgling environmental movement.
When the Baikalsk pulp and paper plant was being planned and constructed, this caused an unprecedented reaction on the part of scientists that were studying the lake here and who were brave enough to stick their necks out and criticize the party, or at least to indicate to the party that this was not the right policy.
The scientists' main concern was about the contaminated water from early stages of the production process. It contained chemicals that were potentially harmful to the lake's ecosystem. The fear was that the long-term natural responses of the lake would not be able to cope with this new environmental stress.